America Meditating Blog Talk Radio Show. We collect wisdom, hear stories, and inspire each other. I'm Sister Jenna. Tune in live from Monday through Friday at 8 a.m.
Ivy Hilton, and you are listening to America Meditating Radio Show.
This is Karina Virginia, and I love the America Meditating Radio Show, and I love Sister Jenna. Bless you all. Enjoy.
My confidence comes from knowing there is a force, a power, greater than myself, that I'm a part of, and is also a part of me.
We're all interconnected. We're all in this together.
You start questioning things. Why is it like this? Is God the person with the old white beard?
I just fell really hard. I don't want to be carrying that anymore.
To ask these questions is really the privilege of being human.
Hope is the simple belief that things can change.
I don't know why, I just know I have to be there. I just have to be there.
I believe in the things that I see and touch and hear.
The way I look at it, God brought me into this world for a purpose. The same as God brought every human being into this world for a purpose.
To believe.
Take a break. Breathe. Why don't you visit the Peace Village Learning and Retreat Center, 518-589-5000.
Reach out and touch somebody's hand.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to America Meditating Radio. I'm your host, Sister Jenna. We're broadcasting from the beautiful Meditation Museum in the nation's capital, and Believe television series is underway, and there is such a shift in communities, in the way that we practice our faith, in the way that we are connecting with each other, in the way that we see ourselves, perhaps more than anything else. And today, the e-journal for Belief was released on OWN Network. So please just type in Belief and go to OWN Network and follow the movement of the Belief series. For 7 days at the Meditation Museum in Maryland, we are offering screenings, so please check meditationmuseum.org. On the National Mall at the Silver Theater on October 21st, we're going to be hosting a screening with an incredible lineup of individuals that Lyndia Grant has put together and has put a lot of work in, and the program is coming along beautifully, just beautifully. So we want to give her a thumbs up for the incredible work that Lyndia Grant is doing, who also has her own radio show. And so she's been really an incredible heart and spirit that I've had the fortune to bump into, and I'm glad I did. And because of Belief, we found each other. So not only is it a groundbreaking television series, but it is also connecting people from various backgrounds, encouraging them to become more than what they are and to learn more about each other and to bridge whatever gap there might be in our conversations or with each other. And so please, we invite you to come and join us on the National Mall at the Silverne Theater as we explore our world, explore our faith, explore our spirituality, and explore our relationship with God, the Supreme, the Almighty. We will have an incredible lineup of people, Reverend Sylvia Sumter from Unity, Georgia Goslow from a national TV journalist. We'll have Dr. Kanu Kogod. We will have Cindy Perlman from the New York Times, Joshua Dubois from Values Partnership, yours truly, the Howard Gospel Choir is going to be there, folks. So we want you to join us, and the weather is going to be beautiful. It'll be in the 70s. So, of course, bring your little sweater and something warm, but I think it's really worth the effort. You know, back in the days before cell phones and airplanes and Teslas, I hope Elon Musk is listening, we rode on camelback donkeys. It took us months to travel from one space to another. When we went on the pilgrimage to find our own purpose and our own spirit, it took a long time to get there. We're just asking you to come out to the mall. It's only a metro stop away. Join us on the Sylvan Theater. Come and meet your fellow brothers and sisters and learn more about who they are and how they show up in the world. And let's make this world a much better place. I'd like to take us into a beautiful meditation as we open our eyes, or you can gently rest them, and move into a place of the original quality of the self and the original quality of the soul. Breathe in deeply. Om Shanti. The time that we choose to be aware doesn't necessarily require me to just sit and meditate. But even while I walk and move around, I can be in a meditative awareness, which is awareness of the soul, the original, eternal, imperishable being of light. For a little while, I'd like to invite you to be present, to be here, and to be now. Allow your mind to settle in the moment, to relax. This meditation is about awareness. It's about becoming aware of your original and eternal self. about connecting to your truth. Let go of your name. And observe yourself feeling nameless. Let go of your gender to discontinue thinking you're a man or a woman. Let it go and observe how you would feel walking around without a gender. Let go of the role that you play and let go of the titles that you own. Observe how you're feeling as you are gradually letting go. Let go of your religion and put it aside just for now. And let go of your nationality and even the language that you're accustomed to. Imagine you have no name, gender, role, title, religion, nationality, or even a language. Ask yourself, how do you feel at this moment? And in this feeling, who would think of you, and who would you think of? The Supreme Soul would think of you, and you, the liberated soul, would think of the Supreme. In this state of absolute freedom, I am truly who I am. A free, peaceful, pure, immortal, eternal soul. Allow yourself to just be absorbed in this awareness. At this time,
welcome back to the America Meditating Radio Show. I hope that meditation took you into a space of rest and comfort. And we are gearing up for the Sylvan Theater at 15th and Independence Avenue, which is right on the mall by the Washington Monument, for an incredible evening of conversation and dialogue led by the D.C. Committee and the incredible Lyndia Grant, who is the main host committee and has put an incredible panel and conversation together in support of the Believe 7-night event of television series. What do you believe in, my friends? What's actually moving you at your core? What is your understanding of belief? Have you ever had some of those moments where you're kind of down and you're not in the place that you really want to be in? And you ask yourself, what am I going to do about this space that I'm in? I mean, am I just going to sit on it and let it take me over? Or am I going to move myself out of it. Because when I'm not feeling my best, I have to ask myself the right question. And in this particular age, we are being called to believe in something greater than ourselves, are we not? We're being invited to raise our level of consciousness and to move our story into a conversation of not belief in terms of just religion, but a belief system. You know, the English dictionary says belief is the state of mind in which a person thinks something to be the case with or without there being empirical evidence to prove that something is the case with factual certainty. So when we walk around carrying our belief systems, is it something very, very subtle? Or is it something really physical and gross? You know, some people say, if I see it, I'll believe it. But is it true? If you see it, will you really believe it? Is it that important? I invite you to take a moment just to think about that as we honor these next few days of exploring Oprah Winfrey's belief series. We came on board a few months ago not really knowing what to expect other than we wanted to support an organization and a company that was actually helping us to invite folks in the world to become a little bit more elevated, a little bit more aware of their own lives and their own stories. And so we really invite you to go on to the Believe Series Network and really hold that awareness in your consciousness and see what best you can do in moving your story forward. You're listening to America Meditating Radio Show, and today we have the amazing Lyndia Grant, who has been coordinating the D.C. Committee Belief Conversation for the past few months. She has exemplified to me a wonderful personality, a woman of fervor and spirit. She's a journalist. She's working in her degree field of communications and having worked for the past 8 years for the religious columnist for the Washington Informer, you know, Lyndia's really expanding her work. She is an educated and highly influential, successful businesswoman in Washington, D.C., and she's opened to learning more about a lot of folks and about the things that are going on in our world. It was so cute when I first met Lyndia. She said, I didn't even know what a Brahma Kumari was until I met Sister Jenna. And so there's just something about her where she just opens up your heart. And today we're very happy to welcome her on the America Meditating Radio Show to tell us how the program is coming along for the Washington Mall. Hey, girl, how are you?
Oh, great. Thank you, Sister Jenna. So good to be here with you all again.
Welcome. Oh, wonderful. I want you to tell us everything of what's going on, but more than anything else, I want our listeners to know a little bit about Lyndia Grant and what moves her spirit to be of such service in our world.
Well, I've been in church all my life. My mother and father were ministers. They were pastors. And my father made us go to church even when we didn't want to. So now as a 64-year-old adult, I understand that, you know, we couldn't go so far from it because that's all we knew. He played the guitar. They sang. I often thought he should have done like Michael Jackson's dad and made us famous because we could sing. And we would be rich by now, but he wasn't interested in that. He just wanted to use his talent playing the guitar and the organ and the keyboards and the piano and everything. It was just a musical family. But it was also centered around the Bible and preaching and church services. And so, and my family were such givers. Although they had 9 children, they still would take in other children. You know, we would have a little girl that was my sister's best girlfriend next door. Although we had a lot of children in our family, my mom kept her house so clean. And because she said it's not about money. You're wealthy when you take care of your windows, make sure they're washed, make sure your curtains are hanging nice. She thought cleanliness made us who we were. And making sure she taught us, it was what she taught us. It wasn't about money for her. It was about how you lived your life. And so that's what I'm doing now. I'm still doing what I grew up to learn. Live my life, be clean, and help others, and be giving.
Bless her heart, because you are definitely someone that I really wish for the world to get to know. You and I met because of Oprah Winfrey's groundbreaking television series, Belief, which,
yes,
as we know, is airing now on OWN Network between October 18th to 24th. And you have taken the helm of not only magnifying the conversation of belief in this country, but I know that two nights ago you held a wonderful event at the Worley Mansion.
Yes.
And coming up on the 21st, you're going to be putting together, or you are putting together, a beautiful event on the Washington Mall. Before I get into the event, Lyndia, I want to ask you, what's been your experience since you've been on this journey of belief with all of us, Values Partnership, OWN Network, and all the people that you have gathered together over this good cause?
It seems like, I feel like I was Alice in Wonderland. It's like I walked into a brand new place, and it's all this love and caring and kindness. I feel like I'm, you know, just Little Red Riding Hood walking through the forest. It's just, to me, it's been fascinating. It has been love. Everybody's been working together. It was July 7th when I heard Oprah on that call, and my life changed. And so I am so delighted. You know, we're not supposed to worry about what happened in the past, and we're not supposed to think about the future. We're supposed to live for today. And I am doing that more and more right now. I'm thinking about each and every day so that I can move forward. But the future seems even brighter just because of the new group of people that I have experienced just from being a part of this belief series. Especially you. You were the first one. You called me. And I didn't even know Sister Jenna, you all. I just want you to know. A world-class leader. She's so humble. And even when I went to her museum the other day to pick up a donation she was giving us to help with the mall, she went and fixed my plate. I felt so honored that she would feed me. And it was such a good meal, too, Sister Jenna. And it helped me. I could go home and keep working.
Well,
thank
I hope
you.
I made you into a vegetarian.
Well, I loved it. It was delicious.
That's fantastic. Okay, well, I know that belief has been connecting a lot of us together. And for those of us who are in a very social environment, such as yourself and myself, we're not strangers to meeting a lot of new faces and people in the world. However, I have to tell you, what OWN Network and Values Partnership has done in bringing the kinds of folks together with all of our resources is truly magical, and it's a game changer. So
yes,
let's
yes.
move on to Sylvan Theater. Tell me, how's that coming along? What can our listeners do to participate? And let us know what we're going to expect.
Well, first I want them to know that we are having a watch party similar to what people are doing around the country on the National Mall. The same show that's going to be work the fourth night we are going to show on the National Mall. So we're excited about that, and we invite your listeners, if they're in the D.C. area, to come down to the National Mall. If you don't know where the Sylvan Theater is, it's right behind the Washington Monument. So all you got to do is get off at the Smithsonian stop and start walking towards the Washington Monument. You'll see a stage over there. That's the Sylvan Theater. And it's free and open to the public. We're actually going to start at 4:30 with the D.C. statehood rally. They always tag on every chance they get because the mayor of D.C. has that as her agenda, Mayor Muriel Bowser. She said every chance she gets, she would like to, and it's not interfering with our program because we're scheduled to start at 5 p.m. And so Congresswoman Eleanor Holmes Norton is coming by. Some of our city council people are coming by. And the D.C. Statehood Committee is going to finish up at 5, and then we're going to start our program. Georgia Gosley, who is a national television journalist, is going to open us up and introduce Dr. Ife Williams, who is the president of the National Congress of Black Women, who will introduce our own Joshua Dubois, who is head of this whole belief project for Oprah. He's coming out to welcome everyone. And Dr. Ife knows him personally, and she's going to introduce him. Then she's going to also introduce the Howard University Gospel Choir. They have a new album coming out, and they're going to sing and open it up for us. Remember, I grew up in church, so I sounded like, you know, we always start off with a lot of music. So my father played, you know, music. You heard me talking about it. So I had to have how a gospel choir will turn it out. So they're going to sing a couple of songs. And there's another singer who used to be a part of the Howard Gospel Choir. His name is Izzy, the Urban Psalmist. Izzy is flying in from Los Angeles to sing a song, and he asked the Howard Gospel Choir to back him up, and they said yes. So we're going to have three selections
from
them.
And that's going to be powerful.
Sister Jenna, then you haven't heard all of what God has been doing. Dr. Andrea Pennington. She is a medical doctor, lives in Monaco, the French Riviera. She's been on the Oprah show twice, Dr. Oz. She has her own show, CNN. She's a medical commentator, specializes in diabetes, but she also does lifestyle and beauty and has her own talk show. So she's a lot of everything, but she's also a doctor and a very good doctor. Because she helped my co-host and cousin Crystal lose more than 100 pounds. So
Wow. That's
why I love Dr. Andrea Pennington. And she's a young woman. And she has bought her plane ticket and is flying over to Washington to serve as our MC and moderator of the panel. Isn't that exciting? I mean,
that
it's,
is
it's
God's magic and your magic. Fantastic. So what
yes.
should folks do? Because we are going to be posting it on our website. So pretty soon our webmaster should be putting that up. We're going to be emailing it out to our thousands of, you know, folks. What can our listeners do? Because I think it's really important for them to get on the bandwagon and participate, not because of all these wonderful people, but because they also know coming together creates some wonder and magic.
Well, we want them to come, and we included the entertainment so that we can focus on the show that's going to come on. So we are going to have the fourth night. I'm not looking at the schedule of what the fourth night is about, but we are going to watch the fourth night. Panelists are going to discuss it. We're going to have the show first, the docuseries, and then the panel discussion followed by audience participation, similar to what you all did at the Unity Church, Sister Jenna, when you held your panel. So it's the same thing. It's all around having this watch party and us watching it together. We just included a little entertainment just to help get folks out. So that's what it's about.
Oh, no, that's really important. So tell us a little bit more. How can people register? Is there an Eventbrite list? Do you need contributions? Let everyone know so that we can at least amplify the importance of this work.
Go to Eventbrite, the Lyndia Grant Show, and register. And there's a place there for you to make a donation if you would like to. Just go to Eventbrite, the Lyndia Grant Show, the National Mall. You will see it. And you can register, and you can also just let us know you're coming. It's free. But those of you who are able to make a donation, because it's not free on the mall, it's not an enormous amount of money, but we have had to ask for contributions to pay for some of the services that are required to do the event on the mall. Thank you for telling me to say that, Sister Jenna.
No, you're welcome, hon. I know how much it has taken in terms of energy and time. And a lot of folks in Washington, they're used to major corporate sponsors, and this has been just from the heart of Lyndia and all of the friends on the D.C. committee. So we really wanted to have you on the air today. We wanted to bring your spirit into America Meditating Radio family of circles. We want to support tomorrow, so I'll definitely see you out there with my 7-yard robe sari, keeping myself warm and ready to go. And the weather I hear is going to be fantastic.
It's going to be warming up tomorrow in the 70s.
Mm-hmm.
So
exactly.
You know, that's God shining on us even more.
There you go, my dearest. So now, before I let you go, tell the world, Lyndia Grant, what does belief mean to you?
Well, belief to me shows how we are all one. To me, it shows how we're so connected. When I watch the Aborigines and I think about how 50,000 years ago, I think it was so wonderful to hear him trying to pass down his singing and what it means. And although he had no meat on his bones, it's almost like what all of us do in our own families. We have traditions and things that we pass down through the families. And it just makes me feel that we are all connected. And the way you, in the Baptist church, you get baptized, and then watching the two rivers, you know, one where the teenagers who had been in trouble went to the river, and then the next one over on the other side of the world where millions are getting in the water. I just love it. It shows to me how we are one. Take time and look at what's going on each night. You can feel yourself in the same predicament or someone you know that have the same. Even if you can't understand one word they're saying, you can understand that they're connected to God, Allah, Baba, Muhammad, whatever it is people call him, Buddha, whatever. It's all the same, we believe.
So true. Beautiful. Is there a website or a Facebook address that you
could lead our listeners to? Yes, you can go
to
my website, which is www.lyndiagrant.com. It's LYNDIAGRANT. And then you can go to my Facebook page and see all the postings, listen to more and more about belief. Lyndia Grant on Facebook. Just put Lyndia Grant. You'll see three Facebooks, WYCB, my radio show. You'll see all. If you just put Lyndia Grant Facebook, you will see what it is you need to find about the program.
Lyndia Grant, thank you for all the good that you do, and I can't wait to see you on the mall.
All right. Well, thank you, Sister Jenna. Thank you for calling me, and thank you for your contribution and for being my friend. I love you.
Take care. Me too. All the best.
Bye.
So that was Lyndia Grant from the Lyndia Grant Radio Show and also from the head of the D.C. Committee planning this beautiful event on the Mall at the Sylvan Theater Wednesday, October 21st from 4:30 onwards. So just make it be a day after work, bring some food, sit there, be together in community and in spirit, and let us continue to change the world. Hope you've enjoyed our conversation on the America Meditating Radio Show. Remember, no one has the capacity to take away your happiness unless you give them permission. And we are here to love each other the same, so let's do that. I'm going to end today's show with Elijah Ray Band of Light. Guess what? He really loves being here. Take care, everyone.